Edward Johnson is an internationally known psychic medium who can communicate with the world beyond. Edward first discovered his powers at the age of 15 when a near brush with death, the tragic dropping of a hairdryer in the tub of water, briefly connected him with his departed grandfather who had crossed over.
Pa?
Hey,
it's Grandpa. Get up, you damn fool, and put some friggin' clothes on, because I didn't come back to see your birthday soon. Jeez.
Financially driven to get his message out to those who have lost their loved ones, Edward now counsels those who wish to reach the great beyond with abilities he likes to exploit in a show we like to call Out There with Edward Johnson.
Welcome to Out There. I'm your host, Edward Johnson. Bannering the stage area, our audience members are agreeing to be read by me. Now, I cannot control who comes through, or even what audience member will participate in the reading. But if they're hot, that always helps. Our guests are urged not to have expectations. There's no guarantee that the person they want to speak with the most will come through. In short, don't place earthly expectations on heavenly experiences. Remember, this can be an emotional experience, so bring some tissues, some makeup that won't run, and know that you're in a safe place with lots of support. For today's reading, I sat down with Christine Christensen, a 21-year-old nuclear physicist from Alaska, who was hoping to get in touch with the spirit of her favorite childhood star, River Phoenix. Christine, I'd like to welcome you out there, and thank you for being so attractive.
It's an honor to be here, Edward. I'm a huge fan.
Oh, I'm sure you are. Now, let's start slow, okay? Ease into it. Okay. All right, now your favorite color is...
blue.
Blue? Yes, blue!
Exactly!
Wow. Okay, all right, you ready? Now that I've established our obvious mental connection, I'm ready to begin. All right. I'm seeing a building. Definitely a building. And Christine, have you ever been inside of a building?
Well, yes. Yes, I have. That's amazing.
Wait. There's more. Have you ever lived in a house?
Yes, I have. I've lived in three. The first two in Alaska, and the third one in...
Maine.
No.
Damn. Definitely has a vowel in the title.
Ohio.
Yes. Ohio. The heart of it all. I'm sensing a parallel line between you and the spirit I'm trying to contact. And this would indicate similar interests or physical appearance.
I'm hoping for River Phoenix.
Then it's interests. Definitely interests. And I also see a number.
Well, I've seen numbers before, usually in print.
Well, I think it's a house number. Yep. 3621. 3621.
Well, my first house was 3222 Sycamore Street.
That's close enough.
Can you see River Phoenix? Is he there?
I'm getting something about a package. A package that was delivered to you by mistake. Christine, have you ever received anything in the mail?
Yes, almost every day. Except on Sunday, never on Sunday.
Christine, the person who delivered your mail every day, was it a mailman?
Oh my God. Yes, it was. Every time, a mailman.
This person is a buddy, definitely older and definitely a human being.
A human being?
Now, Christine, I want you to listen to me very carefully. Will you go out with me?
What?
No, forget it. Wrong vibe. I see the color red.
Yeah.
Definitely red. Have you ever received anything in the mail that was red?
I'm not sure. There was that severed head a few months back, but I...
Roses.
From River Phoenix?
No, from Wang Chung. It was 1988, and you received a dozen roses by mistake, and they were addressed to Dolly Parton, and they were from none other than Wang Chung.
I remember that. I was so excited because I thought they were from me. Then the delivery boy had to come and take them back because, well, he made...
a mistake.
It's like you're in my head.
One step at a time, Christine, one step at a time. Now, the delivery boy, his name was Chet Charles, some kind of C sound.
Chimichanga.
Yes. Yes, it was Chimichanga, the exchange delivery boy from San Juan.
That's it exactly. How did you know?
Whoa, wait. There's more. I now know the message he has for you.
Is it about River Phoenix?
Christine, Chimichanga wants you to know that taking those flowers from you was one of the hardest moments in his all-too-short life. Never before in his delivery days had he encountered anyone as beautiful as you. And at that moment, he wished the flowers had been from him. But they weren't, so the next day he went out to go get you some, and on the way there, he was killed in a tragic flossing accident.
Flossing accident? How does that happen?
Christine wants you to know that he has a dozen roses waiting for you in the great beyond. And someday he hopes to hook up with you when you're nothing more than a dead, rotting corpse.
Oh, Edward. That's so beautiful.
I know. Here. All hell. Take the box. After Christine's reading, our cameras had an opportunity to catch up to her. She was trying to flee the studio, and here's what she had to say about her experience.
Well, I'd hoped to get in touch with River Phoenix. Chimichanga's story just about broke my heart. I'll never forget this experience, or where I parked my car. Thank you, Edward Johnson. Thank you very much.
Well, as always, there is a chance that the person you want to connect with the most won't come through. Now, this is mainly because they didn't love you that much when they were alive. But in Christine's case, things worked out. I mean, she was trying to contact child star River Phoenix. Who wouldn't want to try that? But instead, she got an express package from Chimichanga. A boy she knew as a child. A boy with a great taste in women. And a bad taste in names. My advice to you this day, my faithful viewers, is to appreciate the message. Even if you're not the one being read, I want you to walk away from the show knowing two things. First, is that my book is available now. I mean, you can go to the store and you can buy it. It's available in print for the literate and audio cassette for the lazy. And second, maybe even more important than my financial success, I want you to know that our loved ones are always around us. They're always with us, even in the shower. If we can just send them a kind thought, an acknowledgement, a simple prayer. See, I believe that if we keep them alive, in our minds, and in our hearts, they're never truly gone. Just fine. For out there, I'm Edward Johnson. Have a good night. Welcome to Out There. I'm your host, Edward Johnson. On the night show, it's very special, because it's on TV.
Edward Johnson is an internationally known psychic medium who can communicate with the world beyond. Edward first discovered his powers at the age of 15 when a near brush with death, the tragic dropping of a hairdryer into a tub of water, briefly connected him with his departed grandfather who had crossed over.
Pa? Well, get up, you damn fool. Put some friggin' clothes on, for God's sakes. I didn't come back from the afterlife to see in your birthday suit. Came back for the women in the showers. They're not here.
Financially driven to get his message out to those who have lost their loved ones, Edward now counsels those who wish to reach the great beyond with abilities he likes to exploit in a show we like to call Out There with Edward Johnson.
Welcome to Out There. I'm your host, Edward Johnson. Now, before we begin tonight, just a couple reminders. The first is that there are no passive audience members. You know, I mean, I've read the cameraman, the sound man, and a chemical engineer in Sweden during rehearsals. Also, if you feel like you may be too frazzled, or too embarrassed, or you're just not attractive enough to be on television, we ask that you please give up your seat to someone who is anxious for reading. Also, it's okay to be a little nervous when you're on TV. That's why I get liquored up before I come out here. But try not to get psychic amnesia, all right? It's been known to happen. Guests, they come out, and they suddenly forget the names of everyone they're related to and everyone they've ever met in their life. So bring a copy of yours or the phone number of Vicky, our really hot cue card girl, because I've been trying, you know? And everything's going to be just... Whoa, Vicky, what's that say? Wow, I don't know if that's physically possible. Hold on. Also, validation is important. Now, I don't know your friends, and I don't know your relatives, which might be a good thing. So, any kind of feedback you could give me would just really help me out a lot, whether that's a simple nod, a yes or no, or resisting the urge to hit me. Whatever floats your psychic boat on the troubled waters of afterlife contact. For today's reading, I sat down with John and Chloe Stewart, a married couple, specializing in fine cheese and nuclear fission. Wow. Anyway, they were hoping to get in touch with the spirit of a long-lost friend. John, Chloe, I'd like to welcome you both out there. Thank you for not parking in my space.
You're welcome, Edward. Your show's a bunch of crap.
Edward, it's a pleasure to be here. John and I are huge fans of your show, and both open to the realm of psychic possibility. Edward, it's about John. Forgot to tell you, but he's a raging drunk.
That would've been nice to know before we started. Okay. Yeah, but that's okay. Mm-hmm. We've had worse.
Okay.
It's gonna be all right. Okay, all right. So hey, let's start slow, all right? We'll start slow.
Walk a bit before we run through the grass of emotion's garden.
Yeah.
Can you see my personal hell?
Okay, Mrs. Stewart. Your favorite ice cream flavor is...
Blue!
Yes! Yes, blue, exactly. Wait, blue?
You're amazing! What else do you see, Edward?
Well... I see a backyard. I see a backyard. John, Chloe, Have either of you two crazy kids in your crazy messed up lives ever seen a picture of, a movie with a scene that took place in, walked past or been in a backyard?
Oh my God.
I was told there would be drinking. Chloe!
Yes! Yes, we both have! My first house had a backyard. My second, my third, and my fourth all had backyards. But my fifth...
Wait. Don't tell me. I'm a psychic. It's what I do. Your fifth house, you know, the one with the windows and door, had no backyard.
John! John, are you hearing this?
Crap, crap, crap. All I hear is crap.
That's it. Exactly. A front door, windows, and with no backyard. My mind is blown.
I'm also seeing a living creature. Might be a man. Might be a turtle, but it definitely has mass. Chloe, John, have you two ever seen anything or anyone that had mass?
Is it too late to leave the set? I don't mind being rude.
I have. I've seen all sorts of things in my life. People and turtles. And they've all had mass.
Yeah, you know, the spirit I'm seeing is to the side. All right, now this would indicate that they are roughly the same age as the person being read, in this case, you guys. Could be a sibling, a friend, or a cousin.
I've had friends before, and cousins.
I'm also seeing a name. Yeah, this being definitely has a name.
A being with a name? It's uncanny! What else do you see, Edward?
More money than we'll ever see for selling us this crap.
Well, yeah, and I also see a rose. It's kind of pretty. It's an expression. It stands for a symbol of love.
Love? Now wait just a damn minute.
Chloe. John. I now know the spirit who's trying to contact you. All right, now, he used to sleep in your bed. And he'd lick your face every morning, John. Every day.
But I was young. I was still finding myself.
Okay, no, not your bed. Your bed. All right? Hey, when he'd go out late at night and he'd been drinking, and he'd have no place else to go, he'd come back home and take a quick one in your slippers.
But I was young. I needed the money.
Okay, again, no. Not your bed. Okay, not your bed. Your bed. Okay? The one you share as a married couple with all the sleeping.
Maybe nobody we know is watching.
It is late.
Got it. Okay. He would sometimes chase his own tail. His own tail around in circles, just for hours on end. Just all round. No, okay, let me think, what else? Oh, okay. When you guys would go out on walks together, you'd have to follow him around with a little shovel and a plastic bag. No, okay, never wore clothes. Never wore clothes. Not a thing. He was neutered at a very young age. That's a big hint right there. Giant. Big old hint. No. Okay. Your dog. Your dog, people. I'm talking about your dog. Your dog.
Oh.
That makes a whole lot more sense now.
Yeah. It does. That's great.
Well, we haven't had a dog since...
Fluffy.
And it didn't seem much point in getting another dog after that one. Couldn't ask for a finer friend.
Hey.
But Fluffy wasn't our age. I'm pretty sure he wasn't 29.
Dog years, hon. Dog years.
It was 1992. The new kids on the block were hanging tough. And MC Hammer had something nobody could touch. And it was also the year that you brought home a small brown puppy named Fluffy, which was a bold name because Fluffy didn't have any hair.
Levette told us it was male pattern baldness, but we didn't care.
We loved him for him.
Now, when Fluffy left, it was just 4 days after he'd been hit by that fall.
And somehow lived.
And it was 3 days after he pulled all those school children from that burning bus.
Without a scratch on him.
And it was just 1 day after he saved all of Cleveland from that giant runaway asteroid.
By using all the trampolines in the neighborhood. I remember.
But on that day, that fateful day in 1992, Fluffy thought it'd be a good idea to see just how many licks it does take to get to the center of a Tootsie Roll Pop.
Three.
It was three.
Fluffy wants you to know that he had an amazing life with you two. He was more than just a pet to you. You treated him like a friend. Like a member of your family. It's something that he hasn't forgotten. He wants you to know that there is a heaven. Dogs do go there. And it's a place that one day he hopes to pee in your slippers again. A place where he hopes to lick your face every day.
Aw, damn.
I know.
Here, use this.
After John and Chloe's read, our cameras had an opportunity to catch up to him. John was sobering up in the bathroom, and here's what they had to say about their experience.
Oh, the pain.
I've always worried that Fluffy left us never knowing how we felt or how much we cared.
On Tylenol.
But to know that Fluffy did know, and that he's somewhere missing us and waiting until we can meet again, is just about the greatest gift that we could ever hope for.
Except for the removal of this pain.
We'll never forget this experience or how many licks it takes to get to the center.
Three, for the love of God, it was three.
Thank you, Edward Johnson. Thank you so very much.
My advice to you today, my faithful viewers, is to appreciate the message. You know, even if you're not the one being read, I want you to enjoy this show. I want you to get up off your sofa, off your chair, off your recliner, beanbag thingy in the corner, whatever you're sitting on. And I want you to know two things as you read. Okay? First, is that this episode's on again at 10. I mean, the ratings are through the roof. You people are the best. And second, maybe even more important than syndication, it can happen, is that the animals in our lives are more than just pets. They're members of our families. They'll never raise their voice at us. They'll never tell us we're wrong. And they'll never do anything but show us unconditional love. And sometimes they'll go to the bathroom in the corner, but the other stuff's more important. So keep them alive. In your minds, in your hearts, in a vase on the mantle, whatever it takes. So take a look around at the people and animals in your life and let them know that they matter today, that they make a difference for the better. It's just a thought. For out there, I'm Edward Johnson. Have a good night. And I'll see you at 10.